कमिंग टू फोर्थ क्वेश्चन, 30 वुमेन वेयर एग्जामिन्ड इन ए हॉस्पिटल बाय अ डॉक्टर एंड देयर हार्ट बीट्स पर मिनट वेयर रिकॉर्डेड एंड समराइज्ड एज शोन. फाइंड द मीन हार्ट बीट्स पर मिनट फॉर दिस वुमेन. चूज ए सूटेबल मेथड. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द मीन यूजिंग सूटेबल मेथड. एंड नंबर ऑफ हार्ट बीट्स पर मिनट 65 to 68. नंबर ऑफ वुमेन्स वर 2. 68 to 71, 4 वुमेन. 71 to 74, 3 वुमेन. 74 to 77, 8 वुमेन. 77 to 80, 7 वुमेन्स. 80 to 83, 4 वुमेन्स. एंड 83 to 86, 2 वुमेन्स. राइट. गिवेन क्लास इंटरवल्स आर 65 to 68, 68 to 71, 71 to 74, 74 to 77, 77 to 80, 80 to 83, 83 to 86. And the frequency is given 2, 4, 3, 8, 7, 4, 2. Okay. Now the thing is, we have to find out class mark. What is the formula for class mark? That is lower limit plus upper limit by 2. In class interval 65 to 68, lower limit is 65 and upper limit is 68. So xi equal to 65 plus 68 by 2. 8 plus 5 13, 6 plus 6 12, 12 plus 1 13, 133 by 2. 2 table, 2 6 jar 12, 2 6 jar 12, 2 5 jar 10. So that is class mark is 66.5. The first class mark is 66.5. Now coming to 68 to 71. Again 68 plus 71 by 2. As if you observe here, the difference between two successive class intervals is 3, right? 65 to 68, 3. 68 to 71, 3. 71 to 74, 3. 74 to 77, 3. 77 to 83, 80 to 83, also 3. Then the difference between two successive class marks also 3 will be. So 66.5 plus 3, that is 69.5. Again 69.5 plus 3, 72.5. So 72.5 plus 3, 75.5. 75.5 plus 3, 78.5. 78.5 plus 3, 81.5. For 81, if you add 3, you will get 84.5. As we are adding 3 children here, 66 plus 3, 69. 69 plus 3, 72. 72 plus 3, 75. 75 plus 3, 78. 78 plus 3, 81.5 plus 3, 84.5. So don't confuse here. As the difference is 3 here, we are adding 3 to previous class mark. So we are getting the succeeding class marks, right? So they said to use suitable method. As if you observe here, xi values are large, right? Since let us use assumed mean method. So that's why here we are finding di. It depends upon class mark children. If xi values are so large, then we have to adopt either assumed mean method or step deviation method. So let us use assumed mean method. The formula to find the mean by using assumed mean method is x bar equal to a plus sigma fi di by sigma fi. So what we have to do now, we have to find out a value. A in the sense assumed mean. How to find assumed mean? One among xi we need to consider as A, that to be middle value. Let us count how many class marks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 means, of course, middle value 75.5, that is our A value. What is the formula for DI? DI in the sense xi minus A. First observation xi is 66.5. Minus A value is 75.5. right? From 75.5 subtract 66.5, 5 minus 5 0, 15 minus 6 9. So what is the DI value? 66.5 minus 77.5, that is minus 9 children. As we know that difference between two successive class marks, class interval is 3, here also difference will be 3. Then you will get minus 6, minus 3, 0, 3, 6 and then 9. Children, did you understand how to find DI? XI minus A, 66.5 minus 75.5. Minus 9, again 69.5 minus 75.5 minus 6. From 72.5 subtract 75.5, 5 minus 2 3, that is minus 3. 75.5 minus 75.5 0. 78.5 minus 75.5 3. From 81.5 subtract 75.5 6. 84.5 minus 74.5 9. Now I have to find out FIDI. We need to multiply FI with DI. 2 into minus 9. 2 9 ja 18. 4 into minus 6. 4 6 ja 24. 3 into minus 3. 3 3 ja 9. 8 into 0. 8 0 0. 7 into 3. 7 3 ja 21. 4 into 6. 4 6 ja 24. 2 into 9. 2 9 ja 18. Okay, if you observe here FIDI values, we have negative values and positive values. Actually, we have to find sigma FIDI, means we have to add all these observations, right? So, let us add first negative values. Minus 18 plus 24, 42, 42 plus 9, that is minus 51. And here, 24 plus 18, 42. 42, 43 plus 20, 63, right? That is plus 63. So from 63, you subtract 51, 3 minus 1, 2, 6 minus 5, 12. So this is plus 63 and this is minus 51. 63 minus 51, we got 12. So sigma FIDI value 12. Let us add sigma FI value. 2 plus 4, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 8, 17, plus 7, 24, 28, 28 plus 2, 30. So, sigma FI value is 30. Okay, let us substitute the values now. X bar equal to, our A value is 75.5 plus sigma FIDI value is 12 divided by sigma FI value 30. 6 table 6 2 ja 6 5 ja. So x bar equal to 75.5 plus 2 by 5. 2 divided by 5 as 0.54 ja 20. 2 divided by 5, that is equal to 0.4. From 75.5 we need to add 0.4, that is equal to 75.9. So what is the mean? Mean x bar is equal to 75.9. So what is the heartbeats per minute for the woman? That is equal to average is 75.9. So this is our fourth problem. Now coming to third question, the following distribution shows the daily pocket allowance of children of a locality. The mean pocket allowance is 18. Find the missing frequency. That is F we have to find out. So daily pocket allowances 11 to 13, number of children 7, 13 to 15, 6, 15 to 17, 9, 17 to 19, 13, 19 to 21, F, 21 to 23, 5 and 23 to 25, 4. So I mean class intervals which is given. And number of children, that is called as frequency, 11 to 13, 7, 13 to 15, 6 students, 15 to 17, 9 students, 17 to 19, 13 students, and 19 to 21, we don't know, frequency is F, 21 to 23, 5, and 23 to 25, 4. And in the question it is given mean pocket allowance. Mean is given, that is 18, right? Actually we have to find the missing frequency, that is F. So this question is an important question. Again, we have to find class mark. How to find class mark? That is lower limit plus upper limit by 2. In class interval 11 to 13, 11 is lower limit, 13 is upper limit. So I mean 11 plus 13, 24 by 2. That is the middle value of 11 to 13. Of course, that is 12. 13 to 15, middle value 14. 15 to 17, 16. 17 to 19, 18. 19 to 21, 20. 21 to 23, 22. 23 to 25, 24. So this is our class mark. It is going to be represented by xi. Since fi and xi values are small only, so directly we use direct method. So now the next thing is we have to find fi xi value. So fi is 7 and xi is 12. 7 12 jar, 12 7 jar 84. 6 into 14, 14 6 jar again 84. Next 9 into 16, 16 9 jar 144. Next 13 into 18, 13 8 is 104, 13 1 is 13 plus 10, 23. So that is equal to 234. Next F into 20, 20 into F, 20F. Next 22 into 5, 22 5 is 110. 4 into 24, 24 4 jar 96. Again we have to find out sigma fi xi. Let us add these all values. So leave it 20f, rest all the elements you add now. 84 84 144 234, 20f you keep it aside, 110, then the last value is 96. 8, 12, 16, 16 plus 6, 22, 10, 18, 22, 25, 26, 26 plus 9, 35, 4, 6, 7, so that is 752. So 752 plus, now you write down 20F. Okay, don't add 22. The remaining observation children. So let it beside, remaining values you need to add. Again here also we have to find sigma fi. Don't add f here. Again put aside, remaining values you add 13, 22, 25, 35, 40, 40 plus 4, 44. So that is 44 plus f, right? So we are finding mean by using direct method, x bar equal to sigma fi xi by sigma fi. What is mean? It is given in the question, mean pocket allowance is 18 children. So x bar is given 18 equal to sigma fi xi is 752 plus 20f divided by sigma fi is 44 plus f. So cross multiplication, 18 into 44 plus F equal to 752 plus 20F. Now distributive property, 18 into 44, 44 into 18, 8 4 jar 32, 8 4 jar 32 plus 3 35, 1 4 jar 4, 1 4 jar 4, 2 9 7. That is 792 plus 18 into F, 18F equal to 752 plus 20F. You write down this as it is. Now what we will do, let us transpose 752 towards left hand side, 18F towards left hand, right hand side. So we have 792 -752 equal to 20f minus 18f. So from 792 you subtract 752, 0, 9 minus 5, 4. So that is equal to 40. 20f minus 18f, which is equal to 2f. As 2 is multiplying here, if you transpose, 40 divided by 2 equal to f. 2 1 ja, 2 20 ja. So what is the missing frequency f? F equal to 20. So this question is an important question, children. Don't confuse, given x bar is 18. Okay, after that we have to do calculation, we'll get the value of f. So this is our third question. Coming to second question, consider the following distribution of daily wages of 50 workers of a factory. Daily wages in rupees and number of workers. Per day they may get 200 to 250, number of workers are 12, 250 to 300, 14, 300 to 350, 8, 350 to 400, 6, and 400 to 450, 10. Right? I mean, given class intervals, 200 to 250, 250 to 300, 300 to 350, 350 to 400, and 400 to 450. And number of workers, that is called as frequency. Daily wages in rupees between 200 to 250, number of workers are how many? It is given 12 workers. And 250 to 300, 14 workers. 300 to 350, 8 workers. 350 to 400, 6 workers. 400 to 450, 10 workers. Right? As we know that when we are finding mean, we have to find class mark. It is represented by xi. How to find class mark? For finding class mark, we have the formula xi equal to lower limit plus upper limit by 2, right? In class interval 200 to 250, 200 is our lower limit and 250 is upper limit, right? So your lower limit is 200 plus upper limit is 250 divided by 2. 200 plus 250, that is equal to 450 by 2. 2 table, 2 2s are 4. Again 2 2s are 4, 1 0, 2 5s are 10. So which is equal to how much, children? That is equal to 225, right? So what is our first class mark? 225. Okay, now once if you observe, the difference between two successive class intervals is how much? 50, right? Difference between two successive class intervals is 50. So automatically the difference between two successive class marks also will be 50. I mean 220 plus 50. That is equal to 275. Again 275 plus 50. That is equal to 325. Again 325 plus 50, which is equal to 375. 375 again plus 50. You will get 425. Once if you observe, children, here the xi are of large numerical values. I mean 225, 275, 325, 375, 425. Is it the better way to find the mean by using direct method? No, children. So we use deviation method. We use deviation method. Okay. So that is, either we can use step deviation method or else we can use assumed mean method. So let us go with assumed mean method. So we are finding mean by using assumed mean method. Assumed mean method. What is the formula to find the mean by using assumed mean method? X bar equal to A plus sigma Fi Di by sigma Fi. Children, what is the formula to find the mean by using assumed mean method? X bar equal to A plus sigma Fi Di by sigma Fi. Right? So, here actually what is Di? Di is nothing but deviation. We have to find deviation. So, what is the formula for deviation? Di equal to Xi minus A. Xi minus A. So, what is A? A is called assumed mean. A is called assumed mean. What do you mean by assumed mean? Assumed mean in the sense, we have to take one observation, one among xi we need to consider as A. So that is the middle value of xi. If you observe here, in this case we have 225, 275, 325, 375, 425. Among this, which is the middle value? Of course, 325 is our middle value. Okay. If it is here, number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Odd number of observations, we will get exactly middle value. If it is even, we can take anything, right? So here, what is our A? A value is 325. Children, did you understand how to find A? A in the sense, among class mark we need to consider as A, that is in the middle value. Now we have to find Di in the sense deviation. So what is the formula for deviation? Di equal to Xi minus A. Here Xi in the sense 225, children, right? Xi is first deviation. Let us find actually the formula for deviation. Di equal to Xi minus A. So coming to first observation, first Xi value is how much? 225 minus, what is the value of A? A value is 325. So from 325, if we subtract 225, which is equal to how much, children? Obviously 100, right? So which 100? As 325 is bigger value, it has sign negative. So the answer is what? Minus 100. Now coming to second observation, that is class mark is 275. Xi value 275 minus A. A equal to how much? 325, right? So second one, 275 minus 325. So when we subtract 325 minus 275, 5 minus 5, 0. 12 minus 7, 5. So that is equal to which 50? Minus 50. Next, coming to third one, here Xi value is 325 minus A value also 325. 325 minus 325, that is equal to 0. Now we come into fourth observation, that is 375 minus 325, which is equal to how much? 50. Once if you observe here also the difference between two successive intervals is 50 only. Next, here Xi value 425 minus A value 325. Children, Xi means these are the Xi values, 225, 275, 325, 375, 425. From that we have to subtract every time our A value. Here 425 minus 325, of course that is 100, right? Since here also, since Di value are, we got somewhat, we have reduced to minus 100, minus 50, 0, 50, 100. Okay, so now let us find out Fi Di, right? So what is Fi here? Fi value is 12 and Di value minus 100. 12 into minus 100, that is equal to minus 1200. Children, we have to multiply Fi and Di. 14 into minus 5, 14 5 is 70, that is minus 700. Next, 8 into 0, 0. 6 into 50, 6 5 is 30, that is 300. 10 into 100, that is equal to 1000. So what we have to find, children? We have to find sigma Fi Di. Let us find sigma Fi Di. So here, listen carefully. We have sigma Fi Di values are minus 1200, minus 700, 0, plus 300 and plus 1000. So these two are negative values. Let us add these two first of all. Minus 1200 plus minus 700, that is minus 900. Then the positive values are 0, 300 and 1000, that is 1300, right? As we are adding, children, I mean minus 900 plus 1300. From 1900, if you subtract 1300, that is equal to 600. With 600, as 1900 is greater, it has sign minus, so sigma Fi Di value is minus 600, right? And then let us add sigma Fi values, sigma Fi, okay? Your 12 plus 14, 26, 26 plus 8, 34, 34 plus 6, 40, 40 plus 10, 50. So sigma Fi value 50. So let us substitute the values in the given formula. A value how much, children? Our A value is 325. 325 plus, what is sigma Fi Di value? Sigma Fi Di value is minus 600, children. Minus 600 divided by, what is sigma Fi value? Sigma Fi value is 50, children. 0, 0, cancel. 325 as plus into minus minus. So 5 table, 5 1 ja, 5 12 ja. So 325 minus 12. So that is, from 325 we have to subtract 12. 5 minus 2, 3. 2 minus 1, 1. That is equal to 313. So what is the mean of the given data? Mean of the given data is 313. So here we used assumed mean method. For finding assumed mean method, we have the formula x bar equal to a plus sigma Fi Di by sigma Fi, right? Here a in the sense assumed mean, a equal to assumed mean. So what is Di? Di in the sense deviation. What is the formula to find the deviation? Deviation Di equal to Xi minus A. Xi minus A. So this is our second question, children.